did in London, ladies and gentlemen. So to catch up to speed, I just graduated from UW Seattle this past June, and I'm currently on graduation trip number 2. My first trip, I went to Maui, Hawaii with some friends, and now I'm heading to Europe with both my sister and her boyfriend. There's a lot in store for this trip, and I couldn't be more excited for you to join me on this journey. The first stop of my European tour starts in the UK, and we're in London. I'm absolutely stoked to experience all of the culture, the people, all of the cars, and so much more. And all of this being in a completely new country. One of the more exciting things that we're gonna experience is Restaurant Gordon Ramsay. So you might be more familiar with a lot of other Gordon Ramsay restaurants, so things like Hell's Kitchen, but this is his fine dining restaurant. It's the restaurant that has had 3 Michelin stars in the last 21 years. Overall, it's gonna be quite the experience, and I couldn't be more excited. Let's get it. Room tour. And room tour. We're flying high, we're flying high, flying high. Baby girl, we're flying high, we're flying high, flying high. Baby girl, we're flying high, we're flying high, flying high. So for our first day, we did what any sane person does while traveling, and that's eat. I was super curious to see what food in London actually looks like. Like, honestly, what even is London cuisine? To answer that question, it's honestly just a hodgepodge of other cultures and foods. Still agree that reason's funny, but not funny. Anywho, for our first meal, we got some Indian food, and it was buttin'. We then explored the city a little bit. We were in Soho, London, which was so fascinating to me because there's a Soho in New York City. It's also really similar. Historically, I got to see how the US was actually born from the UK. Seeing the similarities, but also understanding the historical reasons behind that was just so fascinating to me. I'm telling you, this area really reminds me of New York City. It's crazy.
Crazy.
It's crazy.
Crazy.
It's crazy. European New York. Or is New York?
New York's like here.
Is New York like American London?
They copied here.
Oh. For dinner, we got Korean food, and honestly, it was a little whitewashed, but it's all right. It was still pretty bussin'. I'd like to say we did more, but honestly, for our first day, we're just resting and recovering. London is actually 8 hours ahead from Seattle, so our jet lag was pretty rough, and it took us a minute to kind of adjust and get our sleep schedule in order. We is shopping in Soho.
Trying to beat jet lag.
Yes.
We're trying.
Trying to stay woke.
Okay,
right
no.
Now. Oh, stay awake right now.
Yeah, I was like, that's not the right terminology.
But yeah, that's day one. So today is the big day. We're going to experience Restaurant Gordon Ramsay in its fullest. But first, we're doing some sightseeing to experience more of UK's culture. Coming to London right now because I'm sure as many of you guys know the Queen recently just passed away, which is really sad. But we just passed by like a memorial. So it's crazy seeing the effect that the Queen had like live in person, you know? So like I said earlier, the Queen recently passed away. It was and is such a sad moment in our modern day history. As the country right now is going through a time of transition. Yeah, condolences to the people and the families involved and all in UK and across the world who are mourning the death of the Queen. All right, everybody, it's time. Restaurant Gordon Ramsay, 3 Michelin star restaurant. How was it? What was the experience like? Was it even worth it? First off, kind of embarrassing to say this, but this is my first time experiencing fine dining at this level. Things like fork posture, not having your elbows on the table, and honestly just relaxing and letting the servers do their job. Like, I'm just this kid who grew up in Washington State in the PNW. I'm your local neighborhood US boy. It shows because I blew it. I had a spill. And I was so embarrassed. I've never felt more out of place in my entire life. Like, not in a bad way, but genuinely, it felt like such a different way of living. Literally like a week or two ago, I was just this college kid eating $8 Chipotle in my university apartment. And now here I am taking the 7-to-8 course meal. It was actually insane. The best way that I could empathize and describe it is to compare it with something like video editing. Like, for instance, I intentionally pick and choose use music, sound effects, talking points, and so much more just to better enhance the story. For the first time in my life, I saw the same exact thing, but with food. From every little ingredient to every single course, it felt so purposeful, yet intentional. Ranging from all the flavors, from it to be savory, to then going to the sweets, to the desserts, and then going back to the savory, but then having a palate cleanser. It just felt very orchestrated in such a beautiful way. I mean, honestly, the best words I can describe it is that it all tasted so rich and flavorful. And honestly, even that is just understating. Yeah, just the richness in the flavor. Like, it's crazy. Now, was it worth it? Oh, 100% worth it. It was just one of those once-in-a-lifetime experiences that are just so heavenly. There is no price tag when it's actually once in a lifetime. Like, when's the next time I'm probably gonna go to London? Honestly, my entire life, I could probably never go back. Like, I like to live by that saying that you're only 23 years old once. Things like money, it'll come back. So for me, it was definitely worth going through that experience. Special shout out to my sister for putting that reservation in months in advance. You a real one. Love you so much. From here, we wrapped up our second night by exploring the city, eating some great food, and just enjoying all that London has to offer. So to start off our final day, I finally got some good iced coffee. We mainly just went around the city, explored, ate again, and explored some more. It was actually so much fun. London, thank you for all of the wonderful memories. From all the incredible historical sites we saw, to the beautiful architecture all around the city, to the pretty solid food, and even the breathtaking sunsets, just thank you. I would love to say that we ended London on a happy note, but that's just not how life works sometimes. So the road to our next destination started out rough. Let's just say food poisoning is a bitch. My sister and her boyfriend got hit pretty hard with it. We have our suspicions on what it could be, but regardless, getting to our next location was definitely a tough trek.
That's the way every day goes. Every time we've no control. If the sky is pink and white, if the ground is black and yellow.
Good evening, everybody. It is a little late right now, but I'm spending my evening in Paris by myself. My sister and her boyfriend got really bad food poisoning last night. Yes, today I am on the streets of Paris exploring by myself. This is kind of scary, not gonna lie. You know, I did New York by myself. That was fun, but I think Paris by yourself is a little different, a little scarier. So I gotta be a little more on guard, if you know what I'm saying. First, I'm gonna go check out the Arc de Triomphe. Uber is on the way.
Just the same way you show.
It is so pretty here. Literally, it feels like I'm in some sort of like movie or something. So yeah, usually I'm pretty good traveling by myself. Like, I've been to New York City alone. This is a little different. Being in Paris by myself and just exploring. I think the biggest difference is, one, I don't speak French at all. Probably should have taken a few lessons. So literally, I don't know the language here. I can't talk to anyone. I'm literally just by myself in France. But yes, if I had a word to describe Paris so far, busy, it's packed. A lot of things going on all at once. Now I gotta go find the Eiffel Tower next. All right, let's get it. Holy shit. Wait, this is actually insane. Look at this. This is beautiful. Sheesh. This is like one of those moments in life that just like do not feel real at all. But yeah, honestly, no matter how like shitty the situation is, this is still a good start to Paris. I'm thankful. Yeah, I mean, traveling alone is fun, but honestly, I do hope for my sister and Cole to get better. I've just been realizing more and more that like this stuff is more fun when you're with people that you love and you cherish. I'm excited for them to come back tomorrow. Hopefully they're gonna feel better after a good night's rest. Food poisoning is a bitch, but we'll fight through it. We'll fight through it. The height of the vlog.
That's what I strongly suggest.
I'm gonna call it for the day, and then tomorrow we got Palace of Versailles. Alrighty, good morning everybody. We're continuing our day in Paris. We're currently at, where are we at, Jimmy?
Like the Chateau Versailles.
We are at the Palace of Versailles. It's huge, so huge. Palace of Versailles was phenomenal. Skip all the crazy lines though, we actually just bought a year pass. It was a bit more expensive, but it was like a fast pass at Disneyland, and we were able to fly through and skip all the lines. So we could save time and then actually see the entire palace on our own. As a history nerd myself, it was so interesting to see history in real life. Seeing everything from statues of Napoleon, the architecture, and knowing how it was built, to even just taking in the magnitude of the palace was surreal to me. Like, royalty actually lived here. This huge-ass palace with all the individual rooms made me think why anyone would actually need any of this. I guess it was just a flex of power and superiority back in history, but the artwork kept inside of the palace is also just so cool to see. All the intentional colors and paintings showcasing moments in time is an amazing thing to witness. Now, the inside of the palace is one thing, but the entire back courtyard was also just as beautiful. All the flowers and greenery were just oh so pretty. I'm so happy that I was able to see just the grandness of the fields and just witness the artwork that is the palace. So after the palace, there was just one thing that I wanted to do altogether, and that's go back to the Eiffel Tower. Going by myself and alone yesterday just didn't feel right. So as soon as the sun was beginning to set, we made our journey over.
Feel like sun on my skin. This is love. I know it is. I know it sounds super cliche, but you make me feel some type of way. This is falling, falling.
With that being said, the first two cities on my European tour gradship are coming to a close. What a journey it's been so far. We've done so much in these last few days. Ran around the city of London, ate at Gordon Ramsay's 3-star Michelin restaurant, helped my sister and her boyfriend go through food poisoning, went around the Palace of Versailles, and to now seeing the Eiffel Tower twice. It's been a tremendous adventure so far. Now we've still got 5 more cities to explore in Europe, and they've each got so much history and culture behind all of them as well. It's really crazy to say this, but this trip is really just getting started. There's a Soho in New York City as well.
They farted at Gordon
Ramsay. No!
Jeannie farted at Gordon Ramsay.
No!